Right, okay, let's go. Aki Karimi for BBTV. I'm delighted to be joined by Dr. Steele, Shaquille Thompson, over in Sheffield there. Shaquille, thanks for joining me. You look like you're dressed up ready to go somewhere, man.
Ready to go out. It's hot. Ready to go out. Enjoy the day.
Well, let's talk a little bit quickly before you get on with that about your comeback to the ring. You've been out of the rings since 2019, the end of. You know, you've been out a while. How come you've been out so long? And are you looking forward to getting back into the ring?
Being out so long, COVID might have had a sort of a play to do with that. I've just not been able to get the fights. Don't get it wrong. I've been in the gym. I've been working. I've been putting the work in. But the fights just haven't been coming my way.
Must be quite frustrating for you, especially as you were on a real good roll. How have you handled that mentally and physically?
Mentally, I've just been determined, dedicated, stayed in the gym. You know, boxing's my life. I live it. I live it to the full. So I've been in the gym, been living it, and I've just been working. So when a fight comes my way, which is going to be coming my way soon, just show everyone what it is I can do and just start where I left off.
Yeah, you mentioned working. I've seen, you know, you've been working, sparring with top level guys. You're over in Sheffield. You've been sparring with the likes of Billy Joe, the likes of Kell Brook. You know, so in a sense, this is the sort of experience money can't buy as well, isn't it?
Exactly. So I've been in there. I've been sparring. March, April, I was sparring with Liam Williams for his Andrade fight. Andrade's a tall southpaw, so am I. So I've been getting in there. I've been learning through these 2 years. I ain't been in the ring. I haven't been fighting. So just can't wait to get back in there now.
Yeah, you mentioned a tall southpaw. You're 6'3", I think it is, middleweight. Yeah. You've been out for over a year now. Are you still going to be a middleweight when you come back to the ring?
I'm still middleweight. I'm making it easier than what I did.
Yeah.
Making it easier.
That shows dedication, though, the fact that, you know, even after a year's time, you've not let yourself go in any way, shape or form.
Nah. That's not me. I'm in the gym all the time. I live it. That's the difference between me and all the other boxers. I live it. I don't blow myself up. I keep around the fight weight because I've been ready. If a fight did come, and even if it was a week's notice, I've been ready. I've been close to my weight, so it's what it is.
Yeah, nice. For viewers on BBTV who haven't seen you just yet, tell us a little bit about, you know, your background, like which gym you're based in now, and just a little bit about your background and why boxing is such a passion to you, man.
Yeah, so I'm from Sheffield. I live in Sheffield. I'm in a boxing academy trained by Roger Sampson, Gary Wilson, Keith Palmer. I've had 58 amateur fights, won nationals, won numerous Yorkshire titles, etc. Have had 5 pros, not 3 out, won them all. And I'm the next world champion. I'm the future. Like they say, Sheffield's a boxing city. I'm the future. So I just can't wait to get out there and show you all what it is I can do.
You heard the man. He's the future. And I spoke to your new manager recently, Kev Marie. He's very excited to have signed you. Tell us a bit about that relationship and how that happened.
Yeah. So Kevin, he spoke with my trainer, said, is Shaquille still about? My trainer said, yeah, he's still in the gym. He's still training. This time I'd fight in a year and a bit. And Kevin was like, I think it went like my trainer was like, his contract's running up soon. He's wanting to speak with other people. So that's how I got in contact with Kevin. Had a word with Kevin. He's genuine. He sort of had a plan on paper for me, what he wants to do. I'm happy with it. My team's happy with it. So we just can't wait to get out there and get back in the ring now because I'm eager. I'm itching. I'm itching to get back in there. I can't wait.
Yeah, well, I'm looking forward to it. The last time I see you box was against Pucci, actually, a long time ago now. But it'll be great to see you back in the ring. Now, as I understand it, talking of fight dates, you've got this potential date in September. Tell me a little bit about what's on the burner, man.
So September, I think it's around September 18th in my hometown, Sheffield. So looking to get a few people down there, looking to also show everyone in Sheffield what it is I can do. For those that haven't seen me box in a long time, because I haven't, I just can't wait to get out there and show everyone, and also show the people that can tune into the Fight Zone app what it is I can do as well. Because I, like I said, I am the future. I can't wait to just get back in there. Like I said, I'm itching. I can't wait.
Yeah, you mentioned that's on the Fight Zone app there. Have you been watching it? You know, they've put on loads of shows up in Sheffield just now. I've been there, soaked up the atmosphere. Have you been watching them?
Yeah, I've been watching them. Very good shows, good atmosphere, and I can't wait to be a part of it.
Now, you've said a few times you're the future. You've seemed like a very confident man. Tell me what makes you so confident that you're going to be the future of boxing, and especially in the middleweights.
I put the work in. I'm confident in what it is I do. I put the work in. I work hard, and I'm skillful. They say hard work beats talent, but I've got the talent, and I work hard, so it's going to be hard to beat me.
Yeah. And Sheffield's on a roll at the minute, on a roll. A lot of the lads getting out now on Dennis Hobson shows and around that. Tell me about the importance. You know, are you proud of the history of Sheffield as a real boxing city?
There's so much talent in Sheffield. Name a few. My fellow stablemate, Dante Dixon. There's Dalton Smith, Levi Kinsiana. There's so much talent in Sheffield. We're all going to go out there and show everyone what it is we can do. But talking about me, myself, I'm going to show it. My goal is world title, nothing less. So me and Kevin, we've got our plan of action. We're going to get the fights back in, get myself active again, and then start taking those titles.
Nice. Now, your followers will probably not have seen you. Well, they've not seen you in the ring for a long time. You're not like mad on social media where you're posting all the time. You're a cool low key guy at times. So tell them, give them a message to the fact that you're back on the scene.
That's it. I've been low key, but I've been in the gym. I've not been working. I've been in the gym every single day. Obviously, after my rest days. For everyone that does follow me, tune in to the September 18th on Fight Zone. You're going to see what it is. I'm going to start off where I left off, and it's onwards and upwards on there.
All right, bro. Well, look, it's nice to tune in and catch up with you. I'm sure when you announce this fight date and, we're getting a bit closer, we'll catch up properly in person. The great looks. Come and watch you train as well, man.
Yeah, definitely. You're free to come down, man. About some academy, message me and you can come down and we can have an interview. You can record anything.
Sweet. I'm looking forward to doing that. Enjoy the rest of your day, and we'll catch up again soon, Shaquille. Appreciate your time.
Thank you. Pleasure. You enjoy your day too.
Take care, bro. See ya.